All right. He'll be play-by-play. I'll be Jerry the King Lawler. You'll be...
I don't know what you're saying. Is that a
you'll
wrestling
be the
reference?
Michael Cole. He's not good enough to be JR. He's not good enough to be JR.
Yo, challenge accepted?
No, Gorilla Monsoon. Okay. Right. Yeah, okay. Ooh! I'll be Bobby the Brain Heater. All right, let's do this.
Catches the...
All right. Now...
Oh, what a sidestep.
Space. Right. Nice kick to the midsection.
Ooh, picked it.
He's picking him up. Beating this old man.
Going to the wall. Yep.
Geriatric abuse. Got here.
You can't underestimate this old man, I'll tell you what.
Oh,
ducks right underneath the throw. Oh, what a sidestep.
Ooh,
catches the last mid-punch counter.
K.O. Woo! I have run out of stuff to say already. Let's do this.
Okay. I'm just about to have this. Okay, all right, we're good. Oh, gets caught with the low. Oh, tracking. Yeah, check. Oh, try. I don't know if that was a slope or what, if he tried to do the throw early. Bass has that ground grab, so it'll pick people up, but as you've seen a couple times. Not sure. Oh! That'll do it. Oh my goodness,
nice
run up throw? Who does that? Get ready.
Old man is back down with this beast. Good man. Alright. That was a lot of damage for that throw.
And that wasn't even a counter throw version. That was a standard. Oh, he's trying to sidestep, but that's a tracking low.
Let me help you up.
Oh,
no.
He has one chance. Oh, he lets it go. He's going to kill, probably, because he let it go. Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, he's getting caught by those lows all day. Those one piece.
Up, sir.
Oh! Fuzzied a little bit, but came up just in time to get grabbed. Oh, what's he gonna do with this magic pixel, though? Yo, dancing around a little bit. Oh! Oh, he breaks it! He broke it! And excellent job by Dr. Dodge.
I have to get my drink.
He's just too damn strong. Excellent awareness by Dr. Dog, breaking the throw and getting the last hit in. If you break that throw, I'm not sure what the frame advantage is, like on either end, or if it just ends up 0-0 neutral. All
right.
But here we go. Dr. Dog is up 1-0. Oh, good job. Here comes that low again. Oh, ducks right underneath the throw again. Oh, it doesn't chase him down. With those slow rolls backwards, you can actually chase him down and pick it back up.
Oh! Let me help you up while you die.
So Dr. Dog making an excellent adjustment to all the sidesteps that the opponent was making before. Oh, gets the mid punch. Oh, excellent counter throw. Read that the counter was coming out. Get ready.
Midsections. Midsections go good.
Oh, gets the low sweep afterwards.
Let me help you up.
Oh, there we go.
Oh,
excellent mid hold.
Let me help you up again.
What's going to happen here? Oh, he thought he was going to go ducking like before.
That he's doing right there with that throw that he just hit, that he just won match with.
There's certain grabs that are called catch grabs, offensive holds.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll beat out. He's doing a high attack, and so if he does a high attack, the throw will go right through it and grab. Oh, doesn't chase it down again. Oh, gets the bound, excellent, and wall damage, and I'll do it. He's got to take out this round to stay in it. Ooh, excellent hold. Ooh, reads the third punch. Oh, whiffs and nice whiff punish.
Oh.
And a run up throw. Oh, reads the low wake up kick and I'll do it.
Oh my goodness. Let me help you up again. Wow. That was insane.
As we have Dragon Ninja, the man who cheats and manipulates time and space, going up against Slarix, the honest, lovable, basic training character player.
I mean, to be fair, Dragon Ninja himself is just being manipulated by Ryu Hayabusa. You know, like, if you gave Dragon Ninja any other character, he would probably lose every tournament. But it's Ryu Hayabusa that allows him, you know, it's almost like a symbiote. He's like, I'm just going to use Dragon Ninja to show my ways of the ninja.
Yes. And then he manipulates him into buying every single variation of Ninja Gaiden. Including that horrendous variation of 3.
I heard Razor's Edge was okay.
Oh, Razor's Edge was actually good.
So we've got Slayerix, and I mean, these guys are training partners, so they're going to know how each other to play quite a bit. Slayerix has been steadily improving. Like, I remember when he first came out, and he didn't even know what a punch button was. He didn't know what an actual punch was. He was like, what is a punch? I don't know what that is. We kind of train him, you know, you guys, whole training sessions every week. And Slayerix has come quite a long way. He's now one of the best players in Phoenix. Let's see if he can beat one of his demons here in Dragon Ninja.
Very much. Dragon Ninja's been a demon to pretty much most people. The only two people that have really been able to beat him in tournament have been you and Rambro. But Rambro doesn't call himself a DOA player anymore.
Well, I'm not really a DOA player either, so...
But you still come out and play.
Yeah, yeah. Rambro doesn't even play. Rambo's like, I just play this dead game Mortal Kombat. Well, okay, Mortal Kombat's not dead, but no. You know what I mean.
No, he doesn't even play that game anymore.
Oh, yeah, he just plays Street Fighter now.
Yeah,
that's
he's
right.
Only a Street Fighter V player.
Which, you know, I kind of feel like playing different fighting games makes you better all around because, you know, you learn different things from different fighting games.
This is very true. There's... get off topic of the matches. Slarix looks like he's about to take this round and go
he
up.
He does. That is 2 rounds for him. Now, what's interesting here from my point of view is that in order for me to even have the slightest chance at winning this season, Dragon Ninja needs to finish no better than 3rd.
Yes. For me to take the season or at least tie him, he needs to come in 3rd in the next 2 tournaments, and I need to get 1st.
Well, you know, I think that just means you need to grind hard and make sure that, you know, unplug his controller, you know, slap him at the back of the head, whatever you need to do to make that happen. But only to Dragon Ninja, not to me.
Only to Dragon Ninja?
Yeah, only to Dragon Ninja.
I feel like our fights are fair and honest enough to where either one of us could pull it out, even though I haven't won a match yet.
Because I don't have a symbiote controlling me like Ryu Hayabusa. Alright, so they are really close. That was a great sidestep. Oh, that was... one of those preemptive counters, not trying to counter that kick. He was definitely trying to counter a punch, but a high is a high, and it worked out for him. This could be the round and the match. No, he drops his combo. Oh, but gets the throw anyway. That is one thing that I will say Dragon Ninja is pretty good at. He makes you feel like you don't want to counter because he either keeps on attacking. It's just... The way that he plays, he's so aggressive. You know, you don't want to free cancel anything. You don't want to go into a throw or anything like that. Like, you feel like you have to keep on attacking, which just opens yourself up to counters.
Yes.
And we saw there at the end of the match, Slayerix went for the punch reversal, thinking that Dragon Ninja was going to go with the high punch, and instead he got high counter thrown. We're going to get some wall damage here.
And that is one thing that can benefit Dragon Ninja, or even work to his detriment when a player fully recognizes that he loves going for Azunas, especially the high counters.
And, you know, Dragon Ninja just been barely pulling off each one of these rounds, but it's just enough to make sure that he stays in the lead. Misses that tech up. You know, I don't like Slayerix being quite as offensive. Like, I kind of wish he would just slow it down a little bit, you know, let Dragon Ninja make a mistake, because right now he's on the offensive, attacking, and Dragon Ninja's just taking advantage, like, right there. You know, if I really feel like Slayerix needs to slow it down, like that was great. He wasn't able to quite run in and capitalize on that, but as you see here, you know, he's throwing Dragon Ninja off his game because he's making Dragon Ninja play a little better. You know, he's forcing Dragon Ninja. He's taking advantage of all the openings that Dragon Ninja's giving him, which is exactly what Dragon Ninja was doing to him just a minute ago.
Yes. And like you said, now you notice that he has a slight life lead. Now it's now in the favor of Dragon Ninja off of that one basically whiff punish that he got.
And as we see, both of them are trying to whip punish. Now, I didn't really like that. See, if Slayer X had just blocked, as opposed to like that, that is one thing that I will say Slayer X has a lot. He tries to go for counters, I feel, a little bit too often. You know,
yes.
like there's one thing going for a counter that you know is coming, like a forward punch, countering that third punch. Even then, you don't want to do that all the time. You know, sometimes you want to sidestep, sometimes you just want to block. But, you know, those kind of counters I understand. But a counter where you're just kind of, you don't see the move at all, you just kind of hope they're going to do a move and run into your counter, those are the counters you want to kind of try to avoid using.
In all fairness to Slayer, in that case, he usually does play off of me and Dragon Ninja's tendencies and what we've shown him.
And that is a problem.
It's like, as soon as he recognizes it,
no surprise here. Caught me on UC Campbell's side. What's Dr. Dog going to roll with? Oh my goodness, he's going for the mirror. Is he really? No. I don't believe it. He just wants to check out the costumes. That's all. He's not going to pick it. He's too scared. There's no way. All right. So be it. Let's see what he's got. We got KOF / DOA Cosme versus, you know, I'm at the beach Cosme, but with my glasses, my bookworm reading glasses and braid on. Catches the high. Oh, excellent patience by Dr. Dog there. Ooh, gets a low that time. With a forced wake up. Oh, both with that. Oh no, that's the chance. Ooh, good block by Dr. Dog. Gets a good throw punish. Oh, with the run up sweep. Oh, and a run up throw. Who does that? Good throw punish. Oh wow, it doesn't go for the sweep, instead goes for the high. Oh, no throw punish that time. Ooh, we're going off second level. Here we are. Oh, good block and throw punish by Dr. Dog. Gets him off the wall. As you see, Campbell's going to retaliate. He's on the wall now. Oh, that time had the awareness to go ahead and duck regardless, because if it was a high, he was going to duck it. If it was a low, block it. And we are two up on Dr. Dog's side. Ooh, good sidestep, but nothing coming out afterwards. Ooh, too far away for the throw punish. Oh, seen it one too many times with the first move, and so. All these normal hits that don't stun a normal hit. And now wall bounce will do it. Ooh, tries to crash looking for the low sweep, but no, gets the mid punch instead. Run up throw. Ooh, good choice on the mid wake up kick. Ooh, gets the launch. Not going to go off because the camera takes us to that sidewall there. We're about even life. Ooh, mid kick. Oh, we're both frozen, just staring at each other. What is this brawl? And the throw will end it. Dr. Dog goes up 1-0. Is it the reading glasses? I'm not convinced still. But we'll see. The beach bookworm look. We're not on beach anymore, we're in that danger zone, that DOA 1 Cosmic stage. Oh, who's going off? Dr. Dog in a dangerous situation right now. Oh, just like that, position's reversed. Oh, we're back towards the center. Oh, the immediate holds all over the place. Oh, and that, oh, good tech by Dr. Dog. An excellent ground throw. Just another couple of hits. Another 2P. Oh, no. Oh, what a hold! Gets the high hold to end it. Next hit was definitely going to take it. Dr. Dog's seen that sequence one too many times now. Oh, with the wall bounce. Good damage. Try to position himself. What's Dr. Dog going to change here? Oh, the bounce. Ooh, and another throw. That's, what, 3 this match, I think? Ooh, there's number 4. Evens up. Ooh, looking for the hold. Good conversion off the bounce. Ooh, goes with the high. Gets a nice wall bounce. What's Dr. Dog going to get out of the corner with? Ooh, again, reacting to that jumping kick. Oh, this time he says, no, you're not getting a run up the row. Don't even think about it. Oh, with the mid, and see what he has for a follow-up. He's able to finish it off. Oh, and it does with that special ground danger zone. Dr. Dog fighting for on this tournament point here. Oh, chance to get the run up throw. Didn't come up with a hold. Oh, wow. What interesting positioning. I thought for sure he was going to get it to go off there. That would have been really good. Oh, tries to... I don't know if that was 7K. He's doing like the back handspring, but it got caught by that 6P. Quick elbow. Alright, we're back in it. Sorry for being away, trying to fix up my stick. I don't think I'm going to use it for the rest of today, at least, though. Oh, going for that vortex. Oh my goodness, how many? Is that 1-0? Is that it? Alright. Vortex throws for days. Let's go. Okay. Relax a little bit here on Zack Island. While we watch fireworks. Question is, will we actually see fireworks? Let's make it happen, boys. Oh, catches him running in, and the counter throw. That throw doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but off of the counter throw is just enough. Oh wow! Catches the run up grab off of the teleport, and so he gets the counter throw off of it. Wow. Is he gonna go for the third punch? No, he goes for the throw. Oh, here he comes. Oh, in with the knees this time. Oh, take him back towards the fireworks. Ooh, there's the double kick. The KKK that we're looking for. Oh man, stand each other down. Who still uses the KKK? Doesn't even matter. KKK all around the world. Oh, still going for those mid-punches after all his blocked combos. Oh! Gets right over! What is this? Okay, like KOF Street Fighter, you know, there's like jump over other people's moves? Oh, decides not to go for the throw. Excellent awareness. Oh, tries to get the little corpse up again, but this time Slayerix is ready. Oh, and he does finish it. Mid-kick hold. Oh, vortex, no! Go straight into Strix. Ooh, with the first wake up. Oh, pseudo first wake up. Oh, wow. What a whiff punish. Oh, no! Gets caught during his wake up kick, but takes him into the wall. Oh, wow. Excellent job. He recovered in time to block. Unfortunate for Slayrix. He probably could have finished that if he realized that it was going to bounce off like that. Not, I didn't even know he was going to do that. I would have not been prepared. That'll do it. Go up. Slayrix goes 1-1 now. One match left in the set. Alright, here we are. Industrial zone. Are we going down? Are we going down? We don't know yet. Oh, gets the trip, but that's not enough to... Oh, not even that move hits hard enough to knock down? My goodness, I don't know what to believe anymore. This is the longest I've ever seen him stay on those like graded platforms without being knocked down. Ooh, tries to pull him down. Oh, there it is. I'll take it. The match, or excuse me, the round and the down into the lower section, second tier. Ooh, with the wall splat, so that'll end the combo. Pseudo force wake up again and then to the throw. Using that camera switch around to his advantage. A little disorienting sometimes. Oh, gets a pick up right afterwards, but doesn't finish it. Does too many hits. Oh, tries to whiff punish, but it's too late, and that's got mid-punch held. About even life here. Slayrix has got to do something. Oh, no, that... As long as he doesn't... Yep, that should do it. And the set goes to... UC Campbell. So now we are in losers finals. It's going to be Dr. Dog versus UC Campbell. 3 out of 5 set.